Cisco FTD SSL decryption policy gives the capability to inspect SSL encrypted contents over the network. Otherwise, encrypted traffic such as HTTPS connections, which make up most of the internet content, cannot be inspected. There are two main applications of SSL decryption policy. In the first application, when a user inside the network browses an HTTPS website such as https://raika-co.com outside the network, the content of the website is decrypted by Cisco FTD so it can be inspected. After inspection, the content is re-encrypted and signed before being forwarded to the user. This method is also called decrypt resign method. With this method, Cisco FTD gives its own certificate to internal users instead of real server certificates. From the user perspective, all websites are trusted by Cisco FTD certificate. This method requires that users inside the network to trust Cisco FTD certificate. In the second application, we are the owner of servers or website within the network. Users from the outside the network get the services from our servers with servers real certificate. In this method, we decrypt the content in Cisco FTD so it can be inspected to prevent any outside malicious content from reaching the server inside the network. After inspection, the content is forwarded to the servers within network. There are two points we must note. First, Cisco FTD must have server certificate and its private key, so it can decrypt all content from users outside the network to the server's destination. For this reason, this method is called decrypt noun K. The second point is that the content from Cisco FTD to the servers can be transmitted in encrypted or clear text. When Cisco FTD forward the content to the servers in clear text, it aims to reduce the SSL decryption overhead from the servers. When this is the reason for implementing SSL decryption policy, it is known as SSL offloading. There are four steps to implement first type of Cisco FTD decryption policy. Generate Cisco FTD as internal CA. In the first step, we generate a certificate for FTD. This certificate is distributed to users within the network instead of real servers certificate. This certificate must be trusted by all users inside the network. Configure SSL policy to decrypt and resign. It can apply to all websites that users browse or a specific websites. And then enable SSL policy in access control policy. SSL decryption policy will not decrypt or inspect any SSL websites until it is activated in access control policy. And the last one, test, monitor, and troubleshoot decrypt, resign SSL decryption policy. Then we will browse some HTTPS websites to check the certificate and also monitor the logs and connection events generated by Cisco FTD. We start by generating a certificate request for Cisco FTD in the object, object management. PKI, and then internal CAs. Here we generate certificate requests. This can be generated as a self-signed certificate, which is generally not recommended, but can be used in small and lab environments. If we have an enterprise CA, then FTD generates a certificate request or CSR, which will be forwarded to the enterprise CA to obtain a certificate. We complete CSR and then request the certificate. For example, FTD underline CA1, country name IR, state Tehran, city Tehran, organization RICA, organization unit security, and command name, for example, FTD C1.RICA-CO.LOCAL and generate CSR. Then we copy the content of the request, copy. Then the certificate request must be sent to the CA in order to receive a certificate. If you don't know how to install CA in Microsoft Server, I've already explained in a video named SD-WAN Certificate Authority Configuration in SD-WAN course. And then request a certificate, advanced request. CSR should be requested as a subordinate certificate authority, since Cisco FTD itself acts as a subordinate CA, and paste, and then submit, and then download. For example, FTD underline CA. Then the downloaded certificate must be installed in Cisco FTD. Okay. And then install certificate, browse. Download FTD 1CA certificate and save. This is FTD CA1 RICA-CO.LOCAL organization RICA, organization unit security, and so, and then okay. I've already install another certificate with the same method with the name of FTD underline CA. I just wanted to show you. And then delete. Yes. Notice that the enterprise certificate CA must be trusted by FTD, since it has already signed FTD certificate. To do this, we download the CA certificate from Microsoft CA, add it, download the CA certificate, and then download the CA certificate. For example, CA, and then in trusted certificate authority here. And we can add trusted CA, for example, RICA, and then browse, and then CA, and then, okay. I've already done it. You can search it with the word RICA. I've already downloaded RICA CA certificate into trusted CA in Cisco FTD. Now Cisco FTD certificate is ready and can be used by users inside the network. But don't forget to trust it to the computers inside the network. I've already also trusted by this computer inside the network. But just to show you, These are two certificate, FTDN, Ryko CAA, install certificate, next, and add it to trusted root certificate already. I've already done it for both Cisco FTD certificate and also Ryko CA certificate. In the next step, we have to add a SSL policy. In policy, SSL policy. In our example, we will decrypt all HTTPS websites except, for example, Cisco.com. New policy, SSL policy 1. The default action is do not decrypt. To the description and then save. To add a new SSL policy rule, first don't forget to trust Enterprise CA certificate in your SSL policy, Ryko add policy. And then we can add two rules. The first rule is to decrypt all SSL traffic with decrypt resign action. We choose Cisco FTD certificate, which has to be transferred to the users instead of real server certificate. We don't forget to enable also logging, so we can monitor SSL traffic and corresponding policy. It includes all traffic between all network, between all zone, and the name of the rule is, for example, decrypt all, and then add. In the second rule, again add rule, we choose do not encrypt action, do not decrypt action for Cisco application. In the application, we search Cisco, add to filter, above rule 1. So we expect that Cisco.com traffic will not be decrypted. To monitor Cisco.com traffic, we also enable logging in this rule. Here, do not decrypt, the name of the rule, for all zone, all network, all users, and just for Cisco application rule. And then save. Here we have a warning. Application Cisco . There is no more warning. SSL policy will not work until it is activated in access control policy. So policy access control. Edit. SSL policy, we change it to SSL policy 1, and then save and deploy. Now is the time to test, monitor, and troubleshoot SSL decryption policy. We have to just wait until it is completely deploy. Now we can check HTTPS websites from computer inside the network to evaluate our SSL policy. I browsed three websites, google.com, amazon.com, and cisco.com, to check the certificate and also connection event. we expect that the user can browse Amazon.com and Google.com with Cisco FDD certificate, but Cisco.com certificate will be the real certificate from server. So Google.com, Amazon.com, and Cisco.com, let's say certificate from Amazon, is verified by Raika, Cisco.com. It must be from Cisco itself, from its from IdenTrust, but Google.com, I expect that it's from Raika, but it is not. Probably it's a cache, so check it again with another browser. Google.com HTTPS, and then check the certificate. As you can see, the certificate is Raika underline CA. We also check the connection events. Connection events in the search. For application protocol, just HTTPS and URL star.cisco.com star.amazon.com and star.google.com and then search. So I check the detail of connections. I also add new fields to check the SSL connection, more details. SSL rule, SSL policy, and SSL actual action, and then apply. For example, do not decrypt for the websites cisco.com and decrypt for the website google.com.